Hi guys, I'm Tracy. Thank you for joining me today. So in today's video, I'm going to be going over different types of brushes, and I'm going to break down which type of brushes I think are essential to get a high quality handcrafted brush. I'm not talking about like whether to get this brush or not. I'm talking about what type of brush you should be investing in first before venturing into different types of brushes, more so for those of you who are, you know, like little by little dabbling into handcrafted brushes. So I have 11 different types of brushes, and I'm gonna consider 5 of them essential. So let's start out with like cream liquid based products. So for a foundation brush, I don't think it's essential to get a high-end brush. You can get pretty much identical results using a sponge or one of those really dense brushes from Real Techniques. I used to use those for a long time. I don't have them anymore, but that's not something I feel like you should be getting early. Maybe like later on after you get some of these other brushes, you could invest in a foundation brush. And same goes for a concealer brush. So I mainly use concealer brushes for under my eyes, and I often use a eye brush. And you can use kind of like any old eye blending brush. I had a synthetic one. I can't find it, but I had this really simple blending brush that I found. I think my sister gave it to me and she got it for free. But for under eye concealer application, you can even use a sponge if you kind of like press it together. I think that's totally fine. The downside is a little bit harder to control, you know, where it goes and the amount. It's easy to over apply concealer with a sponge, so I do really prefer using a brush such as the Wayne Goss 16, but you don't have to get a nice brush for that. And another non-essential is a brow brush. It is nice to have one. This is the Wayne Goss 21. When I did used to use a pomade, I really did like using this, and I felt like it did a great job, but I don't think it's essential. You can use a fine tip brow pencil, or use like a, you know, one of those Anastasia ones. They work just fine. So I don't think you should be going out getting a brow brush. But something that I do feel is very essential is to get a good blush and bronzer brush. I think that is something that is very difficult to find on the low end. I do have one brush that, you know, if you're not looking to invest in that yet, is the Real Techniques setting brush. I know it's really small, but I have used this for blush, and it does apply very beautifully, but you know, it's very small. And I have some old Sephora brushes, but I really do feel it makes a difference to get to apply your blush and bronzer with a really nice brush. I do notice a difference in the finish and the way you can control the application. Also, some formulas are difficult to pick up, and you know, sometimes you have to use a particular brush to pick up the product and all that. So I have tons of videos on blush and bronzer brushes. So I do think that is a good place to start if you're just starting out with your brush collection. And then another one I do feel is essential is a eyeshadow blending brush. Now, this is one of the first brushes that I discovered. It was a Wayne Goss 19, and this really changed the way I was able to apply my eyeshadow. It doesn't have to be this one. It could be, you know, even the Wayne Goss number 3. This type of brush is very difficult to copy because, like, for example, this scroll hair, there's just something about the quality of the hairs and the way this kind of glides over the eyes, the way it picks up the powder and the way it applies it. It just looks more polished when you use a good brush. And there's been other blending brushes that I've bought from MAC, and I think some like Real Techniques brushes, where it just didn't pick up product enough, or it picked up too much. And so a brush like this would be very good for a light application. I just feel like that having a nice blending brush makes such a big difference. And the same goes with an eye packing brush. Doesn't have to be a natural hair packing brush. I really like the Rephr 21 because there's something about the way the hairs are laid. This is synthetic, but it has to be cut a certain way in order for those shimmers to pick up and apply in a, you know, in a strong way. I know not everyone wants to have like a very reflective shimmer on their eye, in which case you don't need one, but I do feel like a good packing brush makes such a difference in the way you can create looks, how you're able to get into the very little corners and apply a shimmer in a very dense way. And I just think that it is hard to find something that does that as well as a high-end brush. You can also use your finger. I just try not to use my fingers for makeup because I just don't like getting my hands dirty, but that's another option. I do think though that it's very, very worthwhile getting a nice packing brush or two. And then another brush that if you are going to line your eyes with eyeshadow, I do think a nice liner brush makes a huge difference. I just did a video going over all of my liner brushes. I really like the Rephr number 3. This one you can still get. I have some that are not available right now, but having a really precise point, and I don't know, I've had MAC brushes and other brands that, you know, weren't handmade, that they were either too pokey or they didn't pick up enough product, they weren't specific enough. So I do think a liner brush is a good one to invest in. And then so for cream, blush, bronzer, and contour, I don't think that's essential that you have a nice brush for that. There's so many brushes I've used in the past that did a great job. There was a contour brush from Real Techniques that I used for a long time, and it worked beautifully. It's just when you have a nice cream blush brush like this Sonia G Mini Base, it's just like softer, and it's just a better experience using it. But I think as far as the result, you can get something pretty similar using, you know, any old cream blush brush. And then one that I do think, if you are maybe 35 or older, I do think it's very necessary to have a good powder brush to mainly powder under the eyes. That's the only area that I powder regularly, just to set the concealer. Every so often I'll powder my entire face, but when you powder the under eyes, I think it's very important to have a brush such as the Wayne Goss Airbrush. You can still get this one because the shape is just so perfect for getting there. And because it's squirrel hair, it's not going to heavily apply powder. You can get it to do that, but when you heavily apply powder to any area, it's going to make that area look more textured, more dry, and older. If you don't have texture or anything like that, you can use pretty much whatever you want to powder. You can use a sponge, but you know, if you do have things that are going to come through with a heavy powder application, I think a good brush like this is a very simple way to solve that problem. And I learned that the hard way. I was doing it with a sponge, and this brush actually really changed the way I applied powder, and it allowed me to, you know, use more products, because for a long time I thought it was the powder that was looking bad, when it was actually the brush and the way I was applying it that was making my under eyes look so dry and old. So that's pretty much the brushes that I wanted to talk about. I just wanted to put something out there to give you guys some guidance as far as, you know, which way to go first, you know, more so for those of you who don't have a lot of these brushes yet. And for those of you who have all of these brushes, you know, maybe these types of brushes are ones that you can get multiples of. I know for me, I'm just a sucker for a nice blush and bronzer brush, and that's why I have so many, but I feel like those brushes make such a big difference in how I apply my makeup and how the finished look comes out. So that's really all I have for today. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye!